Hello students, myself Dr. Vinita Rathod, Associate Professor of Zoology, SMB Government PG College, Nandwara. In the earlier videos, we have discussed about the terminology of cell division and the process of mitosis. Today we will study about meiosis. I have divided this topic into two parts. The first part, which is this present video, in this part we will discuss about the prophase first of meiosis. The meiotic cell division, first time described by Van Banden in the year 1883. Meiotic cell division occurs in germ cells of all living organisms. During this process, the genetic material of a diploid germ cell undergoes two nuclear divisions, resulting into four haploid daughter cells. Each daughter cell has one half of the number of chromosomes as they are present in the parent cell. There are two successive nuclear divisions in meiosis as compared to the single division which was found in mitosis. The meiosis is divided into two stages, meiosis first and meiosis second. Meiosis first is also called as reductional division because here the germ cells divide, which are having two n number of chromosomes, and when they divide, they produce two cells which are having half of the number of the chromosome, that is the haploid number or n number of the chromosomes. So that is why this division, meiosis first, is also called as the reductional division, because the number of chromosomes from the parent cell are reduced to the half. The second part of the meiosis, which is the meiosis second, is also called as the equationary division. The meiosis second is just like mitosis, where the number of chromosomes in the parent cell becomes the same after production of the daughter cell. So here in meiosis first, 2n number of chromosomes are reduced to n number of chromosomes, and the cell haploid cell which is now entering into the meiosis second, having n number of chromosomes, and at the end of meiosis second, the n number of chromosome remains into the daughter cells. So there is no change in the number of chromosomes after meiosis second, and that is why this type of second meiosis is called as equationary division. But before a dividing cell enters into the meiosis, it undergoes a period of growth which is called as interphase. During interphase, the cell prepares itself for the process of division, meiosis. Now here, the diagrammatic representation of meiosis is there. In the first part of the meiosis, that is the meiosis first, it is divided into four stages: prophase first, metaphase first, anaphase first, and telophase first. The prophase first is the longest period of the meiosis, and it itself is divided into five different substrates: leptotene, zygotene, picoetene, diplotene, and dikinesis. We will study further in the next slides. Here you can see the stages of metaphase 2, which is again divided into prophase second, metaphase second, anaphase second, telophase second, and after telophase, cytokinesis occurs. So from one mother cell, at the end of meiosis 2, total four daughter cells are produced, which are having haploid number or n number of the chromosomes, but the number of chromosomes which were present in the germ cells were diploid number of chromosomes or the n number of chromosomes. This is the flow chart of meiosis. So before the cell enters into the cell division, it remains in the stage of interphase, and in interphase the cell prepares itself for the cell division. Then meiosis is divided into two phases. So after interphase, the cell enters into the meiosis first. The meiosis first is having all stages like prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase first. All these stages completes and then cytokinesis occurs. The prophase first of the meiosis first is the longest stage of the meiosis, which is further subdivided into 5 subphases, that is laptotene, zygotene, picoidine, diplotene and digynesis. After the completion of meiosis first, 2 daughter cells are produced, which are having haploid set of chromosomes, and the sister chromatids will remain together in meiosis first. As soon as the meiosis first is over, the cell enters into the meiosis second. The meiosis second is again divided into prophase second, metaphase second, anaphase second, and telophase second. After completion of telophase second, cytokinesis occurs, and by the end of cytokinesis, in all, 4 daughter cells are produced from a single mother cell, and all these 4 cells are having haploid number of chromosomes. So from one germ cell, there are production of 4 daughter cells which are having haploid set of chromosomes after meiosis. Interphase. Now, as we know, interphase phase is just prior to the entry of cell to the meiosis, and it is also known as the pre-meiotic interphase. During the S phase of the pre-meiotic interphase, the replication of chromosome takes place. So when chromosomes are replicated, then the cell enters into the meiotic first cell division. Meiosis first. Meiosis first is the stage where homologous chromosomes separate, and at the end of this meiosis first, 2 daughter cells are produced which are having haploid number of chromosomes, and that is the reason the meiosis is called as the reduction division. Meiosis first consists of 4 stages: prophase first, metaphase first, anaphase first, and telophase first. Prophase first. Prophase first is the longest in duration as compared to prophase in mitosis. It takes about 85 to 95% of the total time for meiosis, and it is also much more complicated and complex. The prophase first is divided into 5 sub-stages, that is laptotene, zygotene, picoidine, diplotene and digynesis. Laptotene. Laptotene is the first stage of prophase first, and it is also called as laptonema. Here, the chromosomes start condensation so that they become visible as fine thread-like structures. There is a marked increase in the nuclear volume. A process of homology search, which is essential to the initial pairing of chromosomes, homologous chromosomes, begins during laptotene stage. The next stage of prophase first is zygotene. The zygotene stage is also known as zygonema. This is the stage which begins with the initiation of pairing between homologous chromosomes, and it ends with complete pairing. During this stage, the homologous chromosomes coming from different sexes, that is from father and mother, begin to attract each other, and then a pair is formed, and that pair is called as bivalent. The process of pairing between homologous chromosome is also known as synapsis. Here the homologous chromosomes pair together to form a dyad. In the zygotene, the synaptonemal complex is formed during this stage, and at the completion of zygotene, the paired homologous chromosomes take the form of bivalents. The number of bivalents in each species is equal to the haploid number of chromosomes. The next stage is picoidine. Picoidine stage is also known as picoinema. The process of synapsis formation is complete in this stage. The 2 homologous chromosomes of each bivalent appears to be attached with each other at one or more points, and these points of attachments are called as chiasmata. So the chiasmata formations take place in the stage of pachygene. Here crossing over can also be done. Crossing over is a precise breakage, swapping and reunion between two non-sister chromatids. These non-sister chromatids are the chromatids which are coming from different chromosomes. So crossovers make new gene combinations, and which are an important source of genetic variations in the populations. So according to this genetic variation, this stage is very important in meiosis. The next stage is the diploty. Diploty stage is also known as diplonema. In this stage, DNA recombination is complete. The chromatids continue to shorten and thicken, and the four sister chromatids are produced in this stage, and this group of four sister chromatids is called as tetrads. The synaptonemal complex begins to break down. The paired chromatids begin to pull apart, causing the strands to separate longitudinally. The chiasmata tend to become terminalized as the meiotic prophase continues. Dikinesis. Dikinesis is the last stage of prophase first. The chromosomes here becomes shorter and thicker due to condensation. The nucleolus and the nuclear envelope start disappearing towards the end of the dikinesis, and formation of spindle apparatus is organized. So spindle fibers and astral rays starts developing here. The centrioles migrate away from one another. So this is the end of prophase first. In this video, we have discussed the prophase first of meiosis first. In the next video, we will discuss the remaining stages of the meiosis. Thank you.